Look at this. I got headphones on. I got a mic going. Baby.
If only people could see you now.
Hey, no video. We've gone through this before.
All
No
right, all right,
video.
all right. Welcome to This Commerce Life. This is a podcast aimed at small, medium entrepreneurs focused on commerce. I'm Phil, your host, and Kenny, your co-host, will join us as well. And we're going to talk to you about the world of retail and commerce and how things are changing in the world.
I've got a new setup going. I'm just about to send you a picture because it's funky. I'll post it in socials too. Can you hear me okay?
No, I hear you fine.
Okay, great. Great. So I've got this little Samson mic I'm using, and then I got the iPad Pro 11 inch today.
Oh, you did get it.
So I'm, if you check your phone, I just sent you a picture of my setup, and it is a, cause the iPad Pro third gen. So this is the one they released in 2018, has a USB-C port at the bottom instead of Lightning, which makes everything easier. So I've got basically a USB-C hub plugged in.
Yeah, and then that's the Samsung. Do mine too, because it's the Thunderbolt, okay. Right?
So USB-C.
That's what
the,
yeah, C, yeah. Yeah, which is pretty cool. It's a pretty slick. Yeah. That's a skookum looking computer.
Yeah. No. Yeah. No. So it's an iPad Pro, and then all I did was so
just an iPad Pro.
Yeah, that's all it is, and then you know, like
nice keyboard
Apple
too.
Wants you to buy. Thanks, Apple wants you to buy all their products, but this is like a $45. It's called a Pro case.
Yeah, yeah.
So I don't know what it's like to type on yet. I haven't tried. Literally, this thing's like 3 hours old in my hand. So we'll
That's
see.
It's pretty good though.
It was like, yeah. It's full size keys and the whole bit. So
yeah, right on, man.
So we'll see. Yeah, we'll see. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
How are you?
Oh, okay. You know.
Yeah. Yeah.
A long day, usual.
Kenny and I, this is our second time. So I started the day with Kenny.
And you end the day.
Finishing the day with Kenny.
Come on. Cool. What a day. What a day.
Cool. Yeah, it's kind of cool.
It's a banner day. Banner day. I think this might be Phil's most favorite day.
It is. It's been a pretty epic day. Yeah. It's kind of cool. It's kind of cool
awesome,
to
man.
Start and finish with you. Yeah.
It's good, man. Hey, we got some compliments on Peter's, I guess.
We did.
Got a few people online. Yeah. Linda thought it was really good. So the boss said it was good, which was...
Yeah, the boss said it was good. So we
stayed
in
pretty quiet
business
lately,
a little bit longer.
Yeah. She's going to keep us on contract, which is good.
Yeah. Well, so she's been quiet for a bit, but she did... after she sent you the note about what the hell was going on with my voice...
Yeah,
she said to me, "What the hell's going on with your voice?" So I posted that short little snippet that said, "Look, I'm back. I've got a new mic now." And she was like, "Woo, you're back! Thank you." You know, so I was like, "Oh, phew."
That's funny. And you saw the comment on LinkedIn. My buddy Jordan wants to come on the podcast.
Yeah. I think that's really
super
cool.
super involved in the plant-based space.
I
think it'd actually be quite interesting because it's totally timely, obviously. Like he's like right on trend.
Yeah.
Like right on trend.
Right. We have a few of these guys. So there's your buddy Jordan, which I'll just schedule him on.
Yeah.
Probably
absolutely.
For like next week we're at Global Pet, obviously. So maybe the week after.
The week after I'm at Expo.
So maybe the week after that. Yeah, maybe the week after that. Yeah. And then we did get there's another
I sent you, I think, two in the last couple weeks.
Did you? There was another guy, Alan Williams. And he is, what does he do? Director of Customer Experience at Springboard Retail. So he wants to come on and talk about POS data, how to boost customer acquisition, loyalty.
I think that'd be cool.
Yeah, how leveraging emotional loyalty tactics is so important, and then using customer data to craft a marketing plan for your retail business. So I think he'd be a cool guy to get on.
Yeah,
so
I think that's kind of fun.
We'll get him to get on. And then I thought there was one more actually. I don't know where the other one is. I'm sure. Oh, here. Who's this? Harrison Hunter Reed, serial entrepreneur, international public speaker, world traveler. Okay, I'm going to stop reading this one. I'm not sure he's a fit for us. But anyway, we've there's a whole bunch of these guys, so we just got to figure out. Well,
guns like you and I. I mean, it's inevitable.
Yep. It's kind of cool.
That's awesome, man. What the hell, right?
Yeah.
That's good.
Yeah. Yeah, I love it. I love it.
You haven't, when did we talk to Lori's? Did Lori's go up?
Yeah,
Lori's went up on.
Yeah.
We were Wednesday.
It's all a blur, eh? It's all a blur. I literally have no idea where this week is. We had family day. So if you're in Ontario or PEI, you had Monday off because it's family day. But it's kind of like throwing the whole week off. So I have no idea where I am.
No, and we're off night too, as well, right? Because I can't do tomorrow.
Yeah. And we're off a night, right? I talked to you this morning. I talked to you tonight.
That's right.
I'm not going to talk to you tomorrow. It's a fucked up week, you know?
Yeah, that's enough of you.
It is a fucked up week. So yeah. What do you do?
It's all good in the hood, man. Yeah. It's all good in the hood.
What's going on with you?
Nothing. It was a good day. Got some, stuff done. You know, it's a day of stuff.
Yeah.
Like, it was just a day of a lot of stuff.
Yeah.
Lots of email cleaning up. You're gone for 10 days. And I really did try not to, work much last week.
Okay.
I mean, it didn't work well, but I did try not to work too much. The only thing I really did last week, cause I finally got stressed out. I worked on, my presentation. I put some ideas.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Why?
That was cause I was pinging you probably. I was tagging you all sorts of stuff during the week.
It doesn't matter. Then I got anxiety and I had to do it.
I'm sorry.
That's all. I apologize. I'm sorry.
If I triggered you, but you know what? Like, it's kind of your time off too. So
yeah, but you know what it is.
Kind of shitty if I triggered.
But then if I don't do it, then it's not good either, right? And then I did mine. Then I started thinking about the one we have to do.
Yeah, I like
it went this morning.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
I mean, I did. I liked it. We talked about it at dinner tonight a little bit about.
Yeah.
There's four of us for dinner, but we're all ex ex retail.
Okay.
Different ones. Luch was with us tonight.
Oh, cool.
Which I didn't know. I was a surprise. I hadn't seen Luch in ages, which was
that
really
guy amazing. Is cool.
I love Luch.
I like that guy.
Yeah.
I like that guy a lot.
And then it was two other friends from LD days, and we had nice dinner, but we talked about how even retailers of that size. So what Phil and I were talking about, because we started early this morning, we have a presentation due for next week. And one of the presentation we're doing together is more on experiential retail. And what that sort of means. And I did float the, it doesn't mean buying a Ferris wheel just to see how it went. Got a little laugh at it. So I think that the line works. Because, you know, sometimes you're kind of thinking it just sounds cool. But,
it comes out flat and you're like,
okay, that was a dud.
Terrible. Yeah.
So that worked with the two Chinese and an Italian.
Yeah. Okay. All right. So it won't matter because you and I will laugh at it for sure. And that's all that really matters, right?
But is that good to laugh at your own jokes?
I don't care. I'm with you. What do I care? You know, like
that's all.
Like there might as well be nobody in the room. It doesn't matter to me.
Well, that might be true. That might happen anyway.
Yeah, it's entirely possible.
You know, you get people listen to the podcast ahead of time. I think, well, you know what? Those two clowns don't need an audience, and we'll just leave them alone.
I actually think so. I was thinking about this too, and I was thinking that one of these days, what we should do is. We should walk through the Prezzo on the podcast. We don't have to do the whole thing because obviously it won't fit in a, you know, kind of 40, 45 minute format, but we could knock through it, after Global Pet. If our audience hasn't run away from us and won't mind, we should probably walk through it and make these available somehow. So,
I think we should put them on our Facebook pages, whatever, who cares? I think it's just information that it's all the talk. It's all the buzz now. Everybody talks about experience.
Yeah.
And you know, honestly, what does it mean?
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
And I don't know. I felt good this afternoon. I thought about most of the day. I really did on different parts. I thought, well, you know what? I think it's the good, it's the right topic.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
It's
I think so too.
Topic, so.
Yeah. Yeah, no, I think it's good. I think Global Pet's going to be amazing next week. I think our talks are going to be pretty on point. Like I like really dialed into that conversation with you this morning, helped me dial in some more on the stuff I was doing on the marketing side. And I just, you know, when you find that extra intensity to it, right? And
yeah.
I just kind of like, okay, I got to do this, I got to do that. And then it was just like, I was gone, right? I was just off to the races. So,
and I think that's what's going to happen with mine too, is I, the more I thought about it, now I'll go back and change like probably half of it.
Yeah.
And not drastically, but it's all the tweaks, right? Where, because I thought, this is really, and it would probably be good to tie it. It's a tie-in, right? It's trying to make sure that everybody understands.
The
flow of the, what the flow is. So, I don't know. I thought we had a good session this morning. So
I thought we did.
Pretty happy.
I was pretty happy with it. So
we won't sound like complete losers next week. Well,
we might, but again, the one I'm doing with you, I don't care. Right. Like, I mean, you know, might as well just be a podcast, right? So it's all good. It's all good.
Well, I think that's how we're going to end up treating it anyway.
Yeah. I think so. I think that to me, that's the part that's why I kind of like suckered you into doing this, right? Is I thought, one, it'd be super fun to do. And then two is it's, you know, we put this thing together, but what's more important is we've got this thought thread that both of us buy into. Yeah. Do you know what I mean? Which is really all we need, right? And then, and then we'll just go. So it'll be fine. Yeah.
Because even Amelia was asking me last year, she goes, why are you going again? I said, I'm not too sure how I ended up on this trip.
I have no idea. Chang said, do this. And
I said, I'm not paying for it. I know that much.
Yeah.
But
quite
frankly, I really don't know what I'm doing.
Well, I'm just, I wanted to try and make this available because I think it's an interesting part of your skill set that you haven't really tapped yet, right? Is the ability to share this stuff broadly. Can you hear my dog in the background?
Yeah, it doesn't matter.
You can? Okay.
The dog sounds better than you sounded the last couple
of weeks. I know. This tiny little mic actually picks up. My dog is like two floors up.
Oh, it sounded like she's beside you.
Yeah, and she's tiny. Like she's not even, it's not even that loud. But what was it? Oh, yeah. So, but I think this would be interesting. And I hope you land some business out of it too, right? So I'm hoping that, you know, because you got spare time and everything. So, you know.
Well, I've got nothing else to really do. Right? So.
Yeah.
I mean, I there's, you know, I'm not doing much social media anymore, you know, except during the trip, I took some pictures on Instagram. So yeah, I've got lots of time. I should be able to check on it.
But I don't think that breaks any of your digital minimalism stuff, right? Because I think that's about sharing, because your shots are always beautiful, right? So I don't think that's about, you know, I don't think
I
that's
like taking
about,
pictures,
you know, yeah,
I like Instagram pictures.
Instagram's just pictures, right?
It's, but you know,
just,
what I still don't have it on the phone.
No, you don't.
No, that was really? All iPad, and because it's cloud, as soon as you get the Wi-Fi, the cloud picks it up. I will not put it back on the phone.
Okay that's right? fair because your iPad you don't use as much as you use a phone. So
the iPad's by beside the bed.
Yeah.
It's only Wi-Fi.
Yeah.
And I don't check every night. I really don't. I mean, on the trip I did, because I like the pictures were, I just like taking pictures.
Yeah.
Right. And I get doing that. So
I get it. Yeah. Nice.
The digital minimalism is still working. I read last week, I read 5 books.
Yeah.
Which was good.
Yeah.
And a nice cross reference of books. Right. So yeah, it was,
I am, I'm reading a good book. I'm going to tell you about it. You didn't even ask, and I'm going to tell you anyway. It is called, it's so good I don't even remember the title. It's called Play Bigger.
Okay, and what's it about?
It is about, so my CEO gave it to me.
Yeah.
And it is about how, it's about how to not launch a product, but launch a category. Yeah. So, so it is written by, there's 4 authors. So there's Al Ramadan, Dave Peterson, Christopher Lockheed, and then Kevin Maney. I will link I will link the book on Amazon and their website in the podcast description. Okay. But it's called Play Bigger, and the subtext is how pirates, dreamers, and innovators create and dominate markets. And so it's really like, it's about how, you know, guys continue to build categories as opposed to launch products. So the most obvious examples are things like Uber, right? And how they broke out of the taxi market and got into this, you know, kind of ride sharing market. But even before that, there's a guy named, which I knew about this guy already, but I didn't know that he did it. But the guy who invented flash freezing for frozen fish. So they talk about him and how he created an entire category. You know, because he went up north. He was a conservationist. Yeah. Before he was a commercial anything, and he saw native people fishing up north and then throwing them on the Arctic ice, and that would flash freeze all the fish and it would preserve flavor and all that stuff. So he figured out, so he went home to the West Coast and started messing around with freezing things on dry ice, again, frozen fish, and then realized that, hey, you know what? It actually tastes better. You know, but there was no category called frozen food, right? Like everything was canned. And so like, you know, back then you could buy canned spinach, canned peas, everything. Right. And so he realized that this worked for fish, it worked for meat, it worked for veggies. And so he started, you know, doing this, but he had to build an entire category around frozen, right? Cause frozen really wasn't a thing. Yeah. Yeah. It took him 25 years, right? Like you think of the categories now, frozen is like, it's a lucrative category, right? And it's a staple in every grocery store, but it took him almost 25 years to build that category, you know, because grocers really didn't buy into the concept, right? So, yeah.
Well, consumers had to, I mean, we still have arguments in this house.
Yeah.
Like when it's not in season, you're better off to buy blueberries frozen.
Yeah.
The frozen category, first off, the vegetables are, because they're flash frozen, they're, you know, an apple that comes from even the Okanagan takes a week to get to the store. By the time it gets here, there's nothing left in it.
Yeah.
Ones that are picked and flash frozen or flash freeze, frozen? Freeze? What's the word? Whatever the word is.
I don't know what the word
is. I don't know what it is. Is there a word?
Flash frozen?
Okay, someone's going to have to chime in on this one. Linda, when you hear this one, just send us what we're supposed to say. Whatever the word we're looking for is that you're better off to do it that way because it holds nutrients.
Yeah.
Whenever they flash frozen
to it. Frozen versus
frozen. Because Amelia and I have those arguments, and I tell her, you're better off to buy frozen. Like, seriously.
Yeah.
When it's done that way, it's everything's still there.
Yeah.
All the other fruit's been, it's been a week or 3 weeks since they picked it. What do you think's left in it?
Yeah. It's pretty cool. Neat, right? So it's kind of like, so the book is all about how do you build categories as opposed to, I'm only like a third of the way through the book. But it's pretty interesting so far. So it's really about like, you know, all these guys, the Ubers of the world, what do they do that's different that, you know, makes them not a follower? It doesn't make them a competitor to taxis, but they literally took taxis and kind of shoved them in the back seat and went a whole different direction, right? So, so very interesting. Cool. Yeah.
That sounds
so
cool.
That's my book. Yeah.
That's good. Yeah. So but good. I just started another one too. It's called Nine Lies About Work. Free Thinking Leader's Guide to the Real World.
Okay.
So I just picked that up a couple of weeks ago. I'm going to start that one.
Okay. That's interesting. I'm
supposed to be talking about how you sort of capitalize on your strengths and shore up on your weaknesses a little bit and just build work culture and all this kind of fun stuff.
Yeah. But it's nine all lies, the shite, though.
Nine lies.
Okay.
What the nine lies about work? Or nine lies I tell you, but what the hell is it? Nine lies about work.
Okay. Okay. Interesting.
You know what I did? When I dropped all the social media, I went on to LinkedIn. I think I found Gates and a few of those guys and, you know, the books that they recommended to read for the year. And I just went on Amazon and ordered a bunch of them. Right.
Yeah.
And then I don't know what, I found a couple books in the house, probably Carly's, some stuff on the Middle East, and I'm reading some stuff when I'm in Mexico, and I ordered a bunch more stuff.
Yeah.
Right. I just find you that, honestly, if you get back to reading, it's so much nicer than the bloody distraction of all the social mediums. Like, honestly, the amount of time I waste on or wasted was ridiculous. I just know it.
Yeah.
I can read again. I mean, seriously, I never had time to read, which sounds so stupid, but.
No, I mean, look, you give up stuff along the way, right? Like, even the two of us, right? Like, we do stuff that we love. But you give up stuff along the way, right? Because
you have to. Something's got to give.
You know, like, it's finite, right? There's just not enough time. Like, if I couldn't sleep, if I didn't have to sleep, I'd get a lot more done. I'd still give up shit along the way, right?
So, yeah, probably.
Yeah, no, it's cool. I'm thinking about other books that I've read that I should be telling you about. No, I think that's it for now. I don't think
I got a couple. I'll tell you next week. I'm going to read a bunch of books when I go to the East. Just a little bedtime reading. Cause I'm actually kind of enjoying it, and I'm enjoying getting back into some different things.
That's cool.
As long as it's not all business. Cool. I've been trying to read. I don't want cause otherwise it just gets boring.
Yeah.
Cause they all say the same thing after a while. Right.
Yeah.
You know what we should do? We should write a book.
No.
Why?
You know what? So the funny thing is, anyone who knows me, so I'm thinking of my friend Jeff Wong, who listens to this, he might be laughing because I always wanted to be a writer. That was my thing.
Yeah.
Right? So right through school, I wanted to be a writer. And I came out and realized that writers make no money.
Right.
That it's like this long, I had a really famous creative writing teacher in university. Her name was Rosemary Sullivan. She's a biographer and a fiction author. She's amazing. She's Canadian. She's fabulous. And Rosemary used to say the same thing all the time. She would say, you know, writing is like this lonely road, you know, for the long distance runner. Right. And she's right. Right. And like somewhere along the way, I went, fuck this shit. I can make money. You know,
I don't think you're right.
One day, right.
Yeah, I think you write to write.
Yeah.
It's one of those things. You know, you paint to paint, and you play music to play music. If you're trying to make a living at those things,
no, not so much.
It's tough. It's doable. It's doable. Yeah. No, it's but it's you're yeah. you're definitely not yeah. playing the odds.
Yeah. Well, I mean, so now I make money at writing, right? Because I actually write, and I get paid for it. But it's not the same thing, right? Cause it's not fiction writing. It's, you know, blog articles and things like that. Right. So I do a lot of that.
So, I did that too, buddy. You know, I London Drugs didn't have a blog.
Yeah.
My blog
was your blog.
Yeah? Was their blog in a sense for a while. Yeah. Because I remember talking to marketing and I said, well, really we should get marketing. And said, listen, by the time we get our shit together and get this done, just start writing.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
What was it called?
It was
I had kenscool.com.
Yeah, I remember that. Yeah. You're like the trailblazer. You were doing it well before.
Oh, shit. Way before anybody in the industry was doing it.
Yeah.
Way before.
Got their shit together. Yeah.
Oh, my God. Way before.
Yeah.
I mean, there was bloggers. I was not even close to being the first blogger. Definitively the first blogger one of the first bloggers in retail.
Yeah.
I'll bet the house. Yeah. I was the first buyer in the world blogging.
I think so.
There's no freaking way. There's nobody.
You might be the only buyer that's blogging still.
Wow. I haven't read a single buyer.
I haven't read a single, lots of ex buyers.
No, someone. Oh,
but I've not read a buyer. I've not read a buyer, post anywhere. Anywhere.
You just haven't looked hard enough.
Maybe, but I don't think so. I think between you and I, we crossed a lot of paths, right? And so if we hadn't seen, have you seen one? I haven't seen one.
No, but I don't really look. And I don't write anymore. I mean, that way, I don't.
Yeah.
I mean, now it's morphed into this, right? Where it's just a different form of blogging.
Yeah. Yeah, in essence.
It's a podcast format. But I mean, yeah. I wrote the way I talk and I talk the way I write.
Yeah, yeah.
Right. So basically, yeah, yeah. I mean, yeah. I just have people laugh. They said, "Oh my God, I could hear you. I could hear you reading." Sad on a whole bunch of levels.
I like that. I think that's the thing. Like I think that's
called authenticity.
Yeah. Yeah,
like basically, what you see is what you get. Except nobody can see us, thank God. But
yeah, no. Thank God. Well, we tried that. Nobody wanted to see us.
I told you that before, so, we started that.
Yeah,
we've got radio faces.
Yeah, we do. We do.
not everybody's meant for the big screen, right?
Oh man.
But I did like that. That's one other thing. You know, I mean, it's. This is where I think even in the industry, like we're going to go to next week, is those are the things that if they want to be, if you want to, you want to be the expert. And again, we're talking about, we talked about this tonight at dinner again.
Yep.
You want to do the experience and things like that is, I'll give you the example we talked tonight. Buddy has one of the, I can't remember the, what's the jacket? Not icebreaker. I don't know, some freaking line of jacket that I don't shit about because I don't really care.
Okay.
So let's say it was whatever it's called. It was a nice line, right?
Okay.
Get stuff sent to the house all the time on email. Yeah. Always paying him a deal here, deal here, deal here, deal here. And he could buy it online easily, right? But because he's thinner and the fits are a little different, you know what? I'll go to the store and look at it.
Mm-hmm.
The jacket's $150 on sale, whatever. Goes to the store.
Oh,
meets Arcturus. A guy.
Arcturus.
It might have been Arcturus. I don't know.
Yeah.
Arcturus is a pop-up in Metrotown. It was insane.
Well, you have a permanent store there somewhere.
We do.
Van
now.
Has a Arcturus store.
Yeah. But they did a pop. It wasn't a pop. Yeah. It was brand new in Metrotown before Christmas. Yeah. What a shit show.
Yeah.
Honestly, there must have been 300 people in line.
Yeah.
And anyway, so maybe that could have been the line. I wasn't listening to the name of it. But he was telling me, he goes in the store and I had no intention of spending more than $150. He's like us. He's doing well. There's no starvation at all. But he's cheap. Like he likes deals, right?
Yeah, yeah.
Ends up
never pay full price.
No, but ends up buying a $350 jacket. Why? Oh. The guy walked him through it.
Ah, okay.
He said the experience of just this guy that, and he goes, he wasn't selling me hard. He walked me through. Yeah, you can buy this one, and he showed him this. And John said, "Why is this one on sale?" And I walked him through it. He goes, "Wow." He goes, "Yeah, it's a lot more than what you wanted to pay." He goes, "I realize that, but." Sure enough.
But here you go.
You got it.
Yeah.
Right? But it's the same thing we sort of talked about. Online, it's strictly transactional.
Yeah.
That's it.
Yeah.
Now, that doesn't mean if you do nice pictures online and you show it well and you're personal, yes, you can sell.
Yeah.
But for the bricks and mortar guy, here's your chance, man. The experience is when you come into the store, make it worthwhile for me not to buy online. Or if you're in the stores now, start doing some writing.
Yeah.
Do a little blogging. Do a little. Yeah. If you're an expert on goldfish, well then let the world know.
But so, and I think you're bang on. I think that the other piece that these stores are missing is they forget what they're good at, right? Like
totally.
Let's just use Arcturus for an example, right? Is Arcturus can sell online, they can sell in store. They prefer you come in the store because they can do this upsell. And so if you look online, everything online leads you to the store as well.
Right.
Do you know what I mean? Like, and so like that piece is really, that deliberateness is missing in a lot of retailers, right? Because they go, oh, Amazon's online. I got to be online. I got to sell everything like Amazon. No, you don't.
That's a weakness of Amazon.
Yeah. But you have to use online as a tool to get what you want, right? And so if your thing is in store, then use the online experience to bring them in store. Yeah. If you're cheap as stink and you can beat Amazon in every price, then do it online, right? Because it'll be cheaper and your path to purchase is cheaper, but I doubt that. So
I'd question that one too.
No, but you know,
yeah, you're right. Variables,
right? Is
100%.
You know, you have more money than Bezos and you can sell for cheaper, do it, right?
Light it up.
The way to do it. Yeah. So anyway.
But it just ties in well with what we were talking about last, you know, for next week.
Yeah.
I just find that this presentation is starting to really come together in that.
Yeah.
I think maybe we buy our own bullshit too, which probably doesn't help, but I think we buy our own bullshit. I think we've convinced ourselves that
we buy our own bullshit.
We are so freaking smart. It's ridiculous.
I think
that's why we should write a book.
I think we're idiots, and the idiocy has gone so far that we've come back around the other side to smart. So
same, same. I don't understand what you're getting at. Like, well, I don't understand. I don't know why you tried to do that.
Lori, if you're listening to this, scratch it. Just stop. I can hear you writing it down already. Just stop.
All I'm going to say, Lori, if you're listening, Phil started that. That was Phil. Lori, Phil needs help.
Stop writing.
Phil needs help. So we have another Phil session coming up.
We're canceling WWLD. No more.
No more.
No.
No, we can't do that. Jeez.
Oh my God.
We'd have to go pay for coaching.
Yes.
Remember, never pay retail.
Never pay full price, ever.
Same.
Ever. Yeah, never. Never.
Man. Absolutely.
Man.
That's all good.
I'm starting to, so I was going to tell you, cause I've actually been having some fun, cause I've started to sort out some of the, I've started to sort out my marketing shit. So I'm into kind of like, so if you're ever doing marketing, year one is like a shit show, right? Like anywhere that you go, if you're starting your own business, year one is like, you feel like you have no idea what you're doing in marketing. I think like everything else, right, is because it's so chaotic. You've got to organize everything. But I'm starting to get into like breaking up all my layers of presentations, like the way I want to be able to structure my business, how I want to talk to people, and the different kind of like mechanisms I want to use. So I'm starting to like build really cool ads now, which is like, that's the shit, man. That's super fun. So I'm having some super
for Nimi,
so.
Or for
yeah. This is for Nimi. This is for Nimi, and then this is for one of the other clients that I have. It won't let me talk about her, but I'm talking about her without saying who she is. But I'm starting to build shit for her too, which is like super cool stuff. So, yeah,
that's fun though.
Yeah.
That's fun.
Yeah, I think, you know, I mean, at heart, I'm a creator, right? So, it's almost like the writer thing in my career that I never did. Doesn't really matter to me because all I'm doing is creating now. Like, I feel like that's where everything is moving, is if it's like creative based and creative moving, I'm going to be a happy guy. So
yeah. I get that. I didn't tell you last week because I didn't want to get into it with Lori.
Yeah.
And since you were doing such a great job.
Lori, write this down.
It's too late. By the time it runs, it's not going to matter. You know what? We got to talk about Phil and his other problems.
No. Nothing is off limits for you, Lori. You know,
absolutely. But I was thinking the same thing on the holiday, because Amelia goes, you know, what's the matter? I said, you know what it is? Yeah. I said, we've talked about, and I think this is probably where you're, in some ways, where you're at too. I don't like being in the weeds. Mm-hmm. I like the strategy. I like that. Like, I had more fun in an hour this morning just doing that dumb presentation, mm-hmm. because it's thinking, it's the fun shit.
Yeah.
Like even the SKU rat presentation I'm doing, it's just the thinking.
Yeah.
Because to me, all the other stuff is just stuff.
Yeah.
Like, yeah, you got to get it all done, but it's not like, to me, that there's little fun in the admin and there's people really enjoy that. I hate all that shit.
Yeah.
I like the strategy. I like the thinking. I like the, you know, you look at it, bust it up, try to put it back together. Hopefully all the screws were, you know, that came off, go back in. You don't have a pile of extras, but I love doing that.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
And it's one of those things last week, especially after your session with Lori, I wasn't going to bring it up because I was already, my mind's already running down those paths too.
Yeah.
And it's not that I want to bail on anybody. It's I'm trying to figure out better ways to do what I'm doing with everybody. Cause I don't want to start doing stuff that I don't like doing.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's not good for me. And definitively then it's not good for anybody.
Yeah. Right? I think that's the whole reason that you do this, right? Like, I think the whole reason that we do the entrepreneur thing and why we love it so much is you really do, it allows you to gravitate, you know, because all the books that we read, right? Like, so I have all these books that I don't recommend because they're organizational books. So I think if you're, you're in an organization, there's all these really prototypical, like Good to Great, is a really great book, and things that your manager wants you to, everything that, things that your CEO wants you to know, right? Like things like that. But I don't, you know, cause in our line, you know, what really matters is that we get to pick what we want to do, right? Like, I think that's the whole deal, right? I think it's just, sometimes you get so locked up in the things that you want to do and the commerciality of it. You got to take a step back and go, you know, got to take
that's
stock
important,
and go,
but that's not what
know,
I want.
Like, yeah, yeah.
I want to do what I want to do when I want to do it and why I want to do it.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And it sounds like it's a child and it's selfish and it's, but yeah.
100%.
But that's exactly it. That's what I want.
But I've earned it, right? Like if we have millennials that listen, and I love you, right? But you know, at 25, you don't
earn your
have
stripes,
that, right? Right?
You, earn your stripes.
You don't. I don't think. Yeah, I mean, I don't think, and I don't think we mean that in a grizzled veteran sort of way.
No,
like
and not 25 years. You got to do that shit. No,
but you gotta get enough experience to be able to see what it is that you're after. That what you want is something that makes sense, right? And like, I think both of us are in that spot where you can kind of go, you know, fuck that shit. I'm not doing it. Right. Like, yeah, I could make lots of money at it, but I don't want it. I don't care. Right?
Sorry.
Like,
you get to an age where I think you're allowed to do it. At 54. Yeah. I've done enough shit.
Yeah.
I haven't done a ton of shit, but I've done enough shit.
You've done a lot of shit.
And I've done what I don't need to do certain things. And you know why? Cause I just don't want to.
Yeah. Cause I don't give a fuck.
Exactly. I don't care. Isn't that something that you're supposed to earn? Isn't that the whole point of it? Is he supposed to get to a point where I can say, yeah, you know what? No, I'm not interested in doing that.
I think so.
Right?
I think so.
Right?
I think so.
It's hard, though. Yeah. And I know what you're like, even like on your thing the other day, because my problem is always going to be the same, is I don't want to, I know, Lori, so just don't write it down because we're not going down my path again. But I don't write it down. I don't want to disappoint anybody and I don't like not, I just don't like that. Now, we've already done it, Lori. I know. I got it. I can go back and listen to the podcast myself. We're talking about Phil next time again. Phil needs more help than I do. That's it. Instead of that, we're bringing someone else on that Lori can talk to. We have lots of people that have way more problems than you.
Oh, my God. That's so funny. It's so funny.
But it's funny. You know what? Because we talked about, I mean, again, the dinner conversation was sort of around that is, you know, when do you make moves? When do you call it a day? When are you entitled? Or when do you get the right to sort of do that? And Lori would probably argue that it's at any time you want. But I do think you have to pay some dues to me. Like that doesn't have to be, like you said, you don't have to grunt it out and like you said, grizzly. But no, you got to pay some dues, man. Yeah, I'm sorry. That's life.
Yeah. But I think, good for you. That's part and parcel of what Lori's problem was too, right? Like giving away family discounts and things like that, right? Was when is she entitled to, you know, really earn her stripes, right? Like, you know, being able to charge full price, you know, and things like that. So
when you go talk in front of 600 or some people, when is that today or was that Friday? This Friday.
Tomorrow. Yeah. Thursday. Yeah. Oh no, sorry. Today's Thursday. Tomorrow's Thursday. So this week, I think.
She's going to kill it anyway.
Yeah, she's gonna kill it.
Yeah, she'll be fine.
Sorry, she's gonna.
Yeah, kill she'll be fine. She'll kill.
Yeah, it. Yeah. We'll have to ask her. We'll take it apart on the next WWLD.
Yeah, we should really talk more about Lori next time.
Yeah. Or that Jimmy guy who's lurking around all the time.
Is he help? Can we help him? If Lori hasn't figured him out or helped him by now, the hell are we gonna do?
Jimmy, we love you.
That's all good in the hood, man.
Oh man.
It's all good. Oh, man.
I love it.
Anyway.
I love it. I think that's all I got, man.
Yeah, I got nothing for you too. I talked to you already today, so.
Yeah, I know. I'll let you know how the setup goes. I'm kind of stoked about this.
I kind of like what you got going on.
It's a smaller setup. The laptop I have now, this is like it's a 14-inch HP ProBook. Kind of heavy.
Yeah.
Kind of clunky. This thing is like an 11 inch. I've got the 11, not even the 13 inch, iPad Pro going. I'm not an Apple fan. You guys know that, but but I had to try it. So I love the Surface.
I hate to tell you, so, Apple products are just really slick to use. They really are.
They
do it.
They're just really expensive. Like this iPad, you know, the company bought it, but it's got the 256 gig in it. So it came to, it was $1,149, I think was the sticker price on it. So after taxes, it was $1,300.
And it's still not a laptop. Well, it really isn't. You know that, eh?
It's supposed to be, no, the specs spec out at a laptop. So like this will outperform a MacBook Air. It'll outperform a MacBook Air.
Yeah.
But it'll never hold a candle like to this clunky ProBook I just held up. It just won't. You know, and it's short some ports and all that kind of stuff. But the portable option is really, really, really attractive. So I'm actually gonna try and edit this podcast on this iPad.
Oh, it'll be so easy.
So we'll see. We'll see, right? So it's just the file transfers and everything. Like, because this is recording to the cloud, which is fine, but then I got to manage the download back to the iPad, which I don't know how that's going to work. And then I have the set intro and outros as separate files, but those are somewhere else. So I'm going to figure out how to get those onto the iPad so I can use them. Do you know what I mean? Like, so those.
No, I don't.
Like,
I'm just nodding my head in agree. Yeah, for sure. But that's what I tell people all the time. Well, people always ask, well, how is it hard to do a podcast? I said, fuck, it's easy. Don't do anything.
Yeah.
I said, you record, it's cloud. Yeah, and then Chang makes down, somewhat And then I said, I got this buddy who does all the work. I don't do anything.
You know what? Once you get the rhythm, it's actually pretty easy. But this time, because like Apple's weird with files, because they want to grab your stuff and never let go. But then if you come from another ecosystem like Google or Windows, how the F do you get the files onto the iPad? And then more importantly, how do I get them off, right?
In case I
want to get off. So that stuff worries me a little bit. So we'll see.
You'll figure it out.
Yeah, I will.
Say brain power for next week. I need a tech guy, remember.
Yeah, baby. I'm stoked. I'm stoked. I'm going to come to your presentation too, I think.
We're together for the one. It's 15 minutes after. You might as well.
Yeah. I gotta stay, hang out, and then help me hand out my session's Friday morning.
Okay, perfect.
Yeah.
I'll have to hand out sheets or whatever.
Yeah. Oh no, I'm not doing any sheets. Oh,
I did. I got Marcy.
I'm gonna give them a landing page, and then they're all gonna go there and download it. So.
And I gave Marcy. I gave her to print out the Excel sheets because it's too hard to see.
Yeah.
The example that I did.
Well, yours that's is C-Rat, right?
It's only five. It's only five sheets.
But
I want. I kind of thought after. I thought, oh shit, maybe I should take these printed.
Yeah.
So
cool.
Okay, buddy. That's right, it, man. Dude. Got nothing for you.
Okay. Well,
we shall.
You have a great week.
Well, I guess I'll chat with you.
We'll connect with you. Yeah. Once I start working on that, so I'm sure we'll start throwing things back and forth.
Let me know. I'm on your time.
Yeah.
Okay. Your time zone as of Friday.
Friday.
Yeah.
Sweet.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, buddy.
All right. Ciao,
Take
buddy.
Take care. We'll chat
Take
soon.
Care.
Ciao,
okay.
man.
Bye.
All right. That's the end of this Commerce Life. We'll be back soon with the next episode. Thank you for joining us. We hope you enjoyed it. Give us feedback. Tell us what you think. Subscribe. Like us, join us, share us, tell your friends about us. And we hope to see you next time with more commerce news.